can you estimate or predict the lifespan of a transformer? And this is a question that comes up routinely because there's a lot of interest in being able to look into the future and say, when is this asset going to cause me some trouble? And you know, the short answer is there's really no perfect prediction or estimate on how long is a transformer going to live. Now, SDMyers would look at this and say, if you take care of a transformer, we expect it to have 50 years of life. And so you can do the normal diagnostics and respond to it, not just fixing what's broken, but also taking a more proactive maintenance approach so that if you see, as an example, moisture starting to occur inside the transformer, that you address it right away. Then we'd expect you to get about 50 years out of a transformer. But there's really no perfect prediction method. But the good news is I think we can get in the ballpark by other available maintenance data. And so if you're doing your testing, if you're looking at the maintenance data and being responsive, you know about aging or oxidation or moisture, those things going on inside a transformer. And in combination with that, you can do another test that's called Furans analysis. And Furans is very interesting because we can look inside the dielectric fluid and count these particles of Furans. And the way Furans are created is by the natural breakdown of the solid insulation. And so it's widely accepted that the life of that transformer really is the life of that solid insulation. And so what's easy to remember is if you're doing your Furans analysis and you can watch over time to see your rate of aging, for about every 250 parts per billion of Furans you see created, you lose about 25% of the strength of that solid insulation. And so as you watch this information, in concert with your other maintenance data, you can get a pretty good line of sight on how is the solid insulation doing. And so after you get above about 1,000 parts per billion of Furans, you know you're at a situation of heightened risk. So the sad part about solid insulation breakdown is that there's no way to go back and build it back up. Once you've lost the integrity, it's gone. And so what you might see, while we can't predict the end of life, you can say that really the life of that solid insulation has been largely consumed. And then you might take other action to mitigate that risk. So you might say instead of predicting the end of life, you can at least look at when am I at a heightened risk situation. And from there you can take other actions to mitigate, like increasing the routine interval of visual inspections or IR or your chemical testing. You can also see if there's an emergence of these devices that are monitoring the transformers actively, like a DGA monitor, which will watch for the dissolved gas profile continuously. And then you can get much more early notice on an incipient or active fault, or other monitors for temperature and pressure and those kind of things. And there's another type of monitoring called partial discharge monitoring, which is interesting in its own because you can put multiple sensors on a transformer and watch for partial discharge events, and then even begin to start to locate an event inside the transformer. And so as you get into a heightened level of risk, while we can't predict the end of life, you can have enough information where you might make a different maintenance decision to monitor something more actively and then take a different kind of response.